guys, it's me, Stormie, and today we are going to talk about a really cool transit that is going to be coming up as we get to May of 2018, and that is Uranus moving into the sign of Taurus. It's going to be there off and on for the next 7 years. Uranus moves nice and slow, so this is a very slow, long-lasting transit, but because such significant changes need to be made under Uranus's influence, it's a great thing that it doesn't all happen at once. That is good for people, that it doesn't just all happen at once. But let's talk about this. Now, Uranus is our planet of surprises, of unexpected. You know, what Uranus does is when he comes into a space, he uses Uranian energy to tear down structures we have already had in place, right? He's not coming to be this rebellious, revolutionary energy just to be a jerk. He's coming because what we've been doing is not working anymore. We've got to come to the next place. Now, if you think back in these past few years, we've had Pluto and Uranus square against each other, right? And that tore down what our society has looked like. It's tore down some norms for us. It's almost as if it had to strip it down, the entire world, like an onion, peel these layers off, peel them off so that we're left with a higher vibration, right? We're left at the new place. And so that's what Uranus is about. He's coming to take these structures down. And where is he going to do it? In the sign of Taurus now. Now, Taurus is about value, things of value. Finance, your personal value, banking, material possessions, all of that good stuff, right? So Uranus is going to come create some financial changes in the lives of absolutely single every one of us, but also the world as we know it. Now, here's something to consider. I know some of you have asked the question even before I'm making this video, why the heck are we talking about Uranus and Taurus right now? It is what, October? Okay, but here's why. We want to start to understand these energies as we're moving around, because activities that happened April and May of 2017, there were a number of planets moving through Taurus, right? This is a time where we got to see a little sneak peek of what this Uranus in Taurus energy is ultimately going to end up being like. Something that happened globally, as well as something that happened for you personally in both April and May, somewhere in between that time frame, is going to be significant as we get to this Uranus in Taurus transit. And when you look back, you're going to go, oh my gosh. There's the pattern, because remember, astrology is all about pattern and nuance, right? So when we take this Uranus and Taurus glimpse about the big changes that are coming, one, we know that they are likely going to come very unexpectedly, right? And like I said, we're going to be in the area of finance or value. Right? So we know that this means that we could be changing the way we do finances so significantly. Now, one thing, my girlfriend, who is also, we're finishing our doctoral program together, her whole dissertation is on the Bitcoin. And I'm telling you, I think that Bitcoin or some kind of other currency is going to be coming in very strongly, maybe something we didn't necessarily expect. But Uranus is also the energy of technology along with Jupiter. But Uranus is that energy of technology. So we might be moving to a lot more virtual currency as well. Something revolutionary is going to happen in our money and our banking. It will change the ways that we have done things. And this is the thing. It's going to change the ways we've done things or that we've interacted with money before. And it's like, oh my gosh, this is different. I don't understand. It's awful. This is not good. It's not safe. That may be the initial outcry. And then it becomes the new norm. You know what I mean? It becomes something that we're like, why? How did we ever do business without this? How were we? You know what I mean? Because Uranus is also the energy of the future. And when he comes to tear things down, he's not just tearing them down because he doesn't have anything to do. He's bringing the inspiration of the future and saying, boom, here's the future of where we're going. Get your life together. Let's get this in order. And in order to do that, we have to break the way we've been doing things, right? So that's the energies we can expect to see in the world. But I also want to drop a little bit of history on you as well, because I've gotten to do some brush up on the history of this particular transit, because it's always pattern and nuance in astrology. So first and foremost, let's talk about what Uranus and Taurus means. If you have this placements in your chart as well, you maybe want to look it down. And if you don't have a chart yet, click in the description box down below, get a chart ordered so you have your very own to look at, okay? Now, Uranus in Taurus basically is a traditional sign of future money. And actually, if you think about it, and you think about Wall Street, you know, outside of Wall Street, there is the big golden bull, right? There we go. Taurus is that golden money, right? That's where we're gonna follow that money, we're gonna chase that money, we're gonna move towards that money. But when we see Uranus in Taurus itself, it's asking us to see where we have been kept by money, kept by possessions, kept by values that we have thought were correct for a very long time. And that can include things. Oh, Uranus is an energy. It's a very feminist energy, right? So we could see some very female energy stepping into play here as we do these changes. That's one big set of values we could be looking at. It could also be that people start to go, now, wait a minute, why am I paying so much for this when I could be doing this on my own? Wait, why am I paying for this when I could be growing my own food? Wait, why am I paying so much for this when I could collaborate with other people and we can do it better and for cheaper, and we move our finances from the place of having to interact with the government and taxes of money, and we start doing rationing between each other or barter and trade. We could see that coming back hardcore. That is definitely significant when we see Uranus and Taurus. So if you have Uranus and Taurus in your chart, you may constantly be freeing yourself from some kind of value, right? You could really have some different ideas around money and how you do those things, right? So look for in 2018, between 2018, 2025, 26, for some rebellion to happen with things around money. Now, as we look at the history of Uranus in Taurus, so cool, you guys, okay? One of the most fascinating things I think about it is that when we look back, the last time Uranus was in Taurus was 80 years ago, okay? That's how entirely, my goodness, we must be in a Mercury shadow time. Indeed, we are. It is a slow-moving planet. So when we're looking back, though, 80 years ago, we're talking between, 1934 and 1942, because about 7 years, yeah. And what was happening at that time? Well, we had the Great Depression, we had the Second World War, we had things going on Wall Street at that time, didn't we, right? So this is a huge time when it was like we really did. We had more barter and trade instead of huge amounts of banking, right? It was like neighbor, I scratch your back, you scratch mine. And there was a really an idea of working together because there was so little, or there was so much change, or there wasn't huge government providing things, right? So it really was a time over the last 80 years where we can see the effects of Uranus there. Now, pattern. When we look even further into the history of this, there was a time where Uranus was in Taurus and Jupiter was also in Scorpio, and boom, we've got Jupiter in Scorpio right now, and that's going to happen again. It's all going to be coming together in 2018. So here's the deal. Uranus was in Taurus at the same time that Jupiter was over here in Scorpio between 1934 and 1935. So right there again, we see pattern from astrology. Now, what's important about that? Oh, man. What happened to our banks at that time? We had the Banking Act, right? The Banking Act came into effect in the United States. And how about the Social Security Act, right? Roosevelt had it together then. We had some things going on, right? So those are significant financial changes that we've seen as we watch these transits of these energy together. So really a cool time coming up in 2018. I think what we're going to see in terms of banking, I already said this, but I do feel like we're going to see a shift in the money, right? Bulls really do charge. When it comes to finances, they do charge. They charge it on a car. They charge at it. The bulls are about making that money, and they're about having that security, right? But how they do it is also interesting. It's very, very interesting. And I do feel like, I want to state this before I say this out loud, I think that our men in the world need our love. They need our support. I think that we do not always understand what it is like to be from their perspective, because for a very long time it's been like, oh, understand what it's like to be a woman. Oh, understand what it's like to be a woman, right? Not a lot of talk, even on our internet, about what it's like to be a man. However, in 2018, in terms of money, in terms of banking, in terms of value, women's energy is going to rise up. Female energy is going to rise up. And not just women. Feminist energy will rise up, and that can be men too, right? Now, feminist, I want to be clear that when I'm talking about feminist energy, yes, it could be the radical feminist groups that we see rising to the surface as well. But feminist in the truest form, which is an advocate for things to be equal for women, right? Things like that, not the extreme group that says things to be equal for women, we hate men. That's a completely different thing. But feminist energy, I think we see really running to the surface, especially in our banking institutions. I think that feminist energy will play a large part by, in some way, shape, or form, overthrowing something, and then we're able to start something new. And this is not supposed to be that division. Uranus is not bringing this energy to say men messed it up, women are going to make it better. The female energy is just high right now. And if you study astrology, if you study spiritual energy, you can tell we're in a high feminine energy right now. So now, how are you going to be affected when Uranus is in Taurus? First things first, you need your chart so that we can look at where these energies are falling for you, right? Because this is going to be an effect felt globally. This transit, everybody will feel it. But on a personal level, it's going to be transformative for you in some way, shape, or form. Because financially, you're going to get different, right? In areas from credit cards, tax, mortgage payments, owning property, renting property, pension, retirement, certain investment properties, I think, will definitely have a shock and things like that. But whatever it is, Uranus is going to be coming, and we're going to look at these energies about setting you free from the holdbacks that you've had. But in order to see that, you've really got to have your chart. You've really got to know where your Uranian energies, because you have more than one in your chart, right? You have more than one placement with Uranian energies. You need to know where those are at. And here's the thing. The way Uranus comes is he doesn't creep in softly in the night blowing kisses on your eyelashes. Uranus comes and he's like, boom, boom, we got to change this. We need to get you into the future right now. And it's a very immediate energy. Now, here's the thing. If you're not ready to move to the forward and move to the future, Uranus is a shock to you, right? It is a shock, and you will move to the defensive. If you're not ready for it, it could be frustrating. It can feel very confrontational. You can feel like, whoa, how did I get here? But when you look back at what Uranus brought to the table, you're going to be like, wow, why didn't I make that change sooner? Why didn't I ask for financial help sooner? Why didn't I blah, 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 blah sooner, right? Now, how do we prepare? Prepare for Uranus right now. Start getting prepared for this transit. Look over your finances. Be open-minded. When you deal with Uranian energy, you got to be flexible, right? You really do. You have to be flexible, and you have to be willing to hear new information. You have to think on your feet. You have to be willing to move. You have to understand that whatever effects are being brought to you and also globally, you had a part in creating the issue, and now this energy is helping you to create something different. Right? So really an amazing time that we're going to be having and experiencing. I'm telling you, because this lasts for a while, it's nice. We'll have time to adjust before we're just like, I have to redo my whole life. You know what I mean? But be prepared that this energy is coming, as with all of the energies, to move you towards your greatest good. That is the hope of every single one of these energies. But we got to move forward. And sometimes as humans, we don't just rush towards the future. You know what I'm saying? All right, guys, I hope you have liked this video. Comment, share, subscribe. I'll definitely, as we move towards 2018, be doing a few more live talks about Uranus and Taurus. I look forward to doing that for you and probably offering out some cool little gift to be able to look at your own Uranian energies in your chart. Again, if you do not have your chart, click in the description box down below. Get it ordered. I give you a really full chart. You should never have to order another one after you get one of mine. And it is worth it for you to be able to have right at your fingertips, so that as you're listening to me or Barbara or Terrence or Kelly or Michelle or anybody that that you are listening to or studying with, you want to have it at your fingertips so you can follow right along and know your situation, not just the general. All right, guys, I love you so much. Bye.